Are there any other methods of solving this except using the trig identities? I know why you're asking this question. We have the integral of cosine squared x. And let me show you the usual solution first in a usual calculus 2 class. Here, firstly though, do not replace this with 1 minus sine squared x. Yes, we can integrate 1 very easily, but how do we integrate sine squared x? You see, right here, in fact, we are running into the similar situation. So even though cosine squared x is equal to 1 minus sine squared x, but this identity does not help. So what do we do though? Well, there's another identity for cosine squared, and that's the double angle identity. We can also look at this as the power reduction identity. Let me show you. This right here is equal to, just the cosine squared x is 1 half times 1 plus cosine of 2x. It's pretty much the result from the double angle identity. Right? This is equal to just the cosine. We haven't done the integral yet, so let's go ahead and put that down. I have the 1 half on the whole side already. And a lot of people don't like this because who remembers this identity, right? So I understand, but let me just finish this right here first and I'll show you how to do this with integration by parts. However though, when we use integration by parts for this, you will still have to use an identity. But that identity will just be the nicer one, the Pythagorean identity, not this. So anyway though, right here, let's go ahead, put down the 1 half, right? It's just a constant multiple, and then open parentheses for the result of integration. Integrating 1 in the x world is just x. Integrating cosine of 2x, integral of cosine is positive, so it's plus, and then we have sine. And since this is just a number times x, we can just do the following. What's the derivative of 2x? 2 divided by 2, so here we have the 1 half, like that. Remember, whenever the derivative of the inside is just a constant, we can just divide it by that constant, right? Just like that. Or you can just do u sub on the side to verify that. And that's pretty much it. Of course, you can distribute the 1 half and say that's 1 over 2 times x plus 1 over 4 times sine of 2x, and then all done. Here we have that plus c. Yeah, this right here is the intended solution. Now, here is how we can work this out with integration by parts. Here we have the integral of cosine squared x dx. Firstly though, let me break this down into cosine x times cosine x. So here is the integral of cosine x times cosine x. And you might be wondering, why did we do that? The reason is because for integration by parts, we want to pick one part to be differentiated and the other part to be integrated. They are both cosine now. Well, just differentiate one cosine and then integrate one, the other cosine. D and I, right? Let's differentiate cosine x and then integrate that cosine x. Yeah, trust me, it works. Differentiating cosine x, we get negative sine x. Integrating cosine x, we get positive sine x. And now let me tell you, this right here is enough, and we'll end up with a repeating situation. So let me write this down again right here. Integral of cosine squared x. Now, to work this out, this times this is the first part of the answer. So we will get, let's put down the sine first, yeah? So we have sine x times cosine x. And then we are going to multiply these two things and then put that inside of the integral. Remember, we have a negative right here and then times this negative, so it's a positive integral sine x times sine x. Here we have sine squared x right here. Right, sine squared x, yeah, because this times that, so just decay that right here. Okay, this does not look the same as that. But now, for this right here, we can use our Pythagorean identity. Let me show you. This right here becomes, I'll just say, let me just write this down. This is equal to sine x times cosine x plus integral, but we can say this is 1 minus cosine square x. And whenever we use this identity, people are less mad, unlike that one. So I hope you guys are okay with this identity, okay? And then to continue, I'm just going to break them apart. So we still have that sine x times cosine x, but we can look at this as the integral of 1 dx and then minus the integral of cosine square x dx. As you can see, this is the repeating case, yeah? Because on the left hand side, we still have that integral of cosine square x, right? Just like that. So now to finish this, let's just go ahead and add the integral of cosine square x on both sides. So this and that cancel. Let's add the integral of cosine square x dx. And now we will just get two of them. So two integral of cosine square x dx. That will be, this right here is still the same thing, sine x times cosine x. And don't forget that here we have to work out the integral of 1, which is x, so plus x right here, right? And now we can just divide everybody by 2. So ladies and gentlemen, the integral of cosine square x dx equals, here we have the 1/2, and then sine x, cosine x plus 1/2 x, and then plus c. This right here is it. But wait, this does not look like the same as that. Well, don't worry, check this out. Let's go back here. They are equal because right here we have sine of 2x. So we can use the double angle identity for sine. This right here becomes 1/2 x plus 1 over 4. But sine of 2x is what? Well, that's 2 sine x times cosine x. So as you can see right here, we can reduce this and that, so we have the 2. So finally, we have 1/2 x plus 1 over 2. And then here we have sine x times cosine x plus c. So indeed, they are equal. Yeah, so let me know which way that you like more. That's it.